President Biden cancels the sale of 80 million acres of Gulf of Mexico oil leases. There are those, a lot of folks, including the governor of Louisiana, John Bel Edwards, sort of sounding an alarm, saying this is horrible. This could mess stuff up. What do you think about this?
We did some economic impact statements in October of last year when we anticipated where the election was going. So you're looking at up to a loss of $95 million in lost wages, economic impact, especially to South Louisiana with the Gulf of Mexico losing that business. You do have a Louisiana governor who is starting to take more and more interest in this. And I will be honest, we have been incredibly involved in this process. Our organization represents refineries, LNG pipelines, onshore operators, and then we have a very heavy footprint in the Gulf of Mexico. So we do have a lot of activity as it relates to Washington and what's going on. We are actually in the final steps of unveiling a very detailed plan and how to support Governor Edwards and his advocacy to help open up the Gulf of Mexico. The Gulf of Mexico actually has the lowest carbon intensity of any producing region in the entire world, second to Saudi Arabia.
Pardon me, Mr. Tyler. Yeah, look, I'm a big proponent of fossil fuels myself, but it's Joe Biden. It's the Green New Deal. Do you really have a shot?
We believe that we have an angle that we can speak to some of the things that they find important as part of their political agenda. I mean, you're going to need oil and gas no matter what. You can say everything you want to do it, but you are looking at a world demand of about 100 million barrels per day of oil. And even when there was a drop as related to the demand destruction from COVID, it was only about 20 million.
Then right? I understand this is a rhetorical question. And we sort of asked the same thing to Mr. Monclaw yesterday. Why the hell is the president hell-bent on destroying the American fossil fuel industry?
I believe that they're trying to build the airplane while they're taking off. I think that they have, created alliances with certain folks where they think now they're trying to piece it together. And I think it's going to, you're going to have to learn what happened.
But those certain folks aren't American. Why is President Joe Biden, and we're getting what he said he was going to do during the campaign, which was shut down the American fossil fuel industry. Why does this president want to rely on our enemies for our energy sources?
I don't know the answer to that question, but I can tell you it's happened. I've already been hearing about Louisiana companies looking for contracts in other countries. You need oil.
Put your crystal ball out.
Yeah.
How much are we going to be paying for gas by the end of the summer?
So it's hard to predict, but I can tell you the more that they put restrictions on it, the harder it is to operate, the less oil there is, the more you have to bring in from out of country, it's going to go up. It's going to go up. That's the bottom line.
Would $4 surprise you?
No. It wouldn't. I mean, I remember in 2008, I was actually in law school. I remember paying $4.86 in New Orleans for gasoline.
So like we've talked about a couple of days. Look, I'm old enough to remember the OPEC boycotts of the 70s. I understand odd and even gas days. Sorry, no gas at all. Mm. Is it even conceivable to you? Because it is to me, as we depend on the OPEC countries again for our energy source, that kind of thing could happen again.
It would not surprise me, and it definitely would not. And I think it's gonna be eye-opening experience for this administration as you start to travel down that road. And if they're not careful, it's gonna be a big campaign issue in the next cycle. So they really have to pay attention to it. And I don't think they want it to be a campaign issue. I think the airplane is going to have to be built. They're going to realize what they're dealing with. They're going to try to take off. It won't happen. And they're going to come back and have to realize that oil is part of the equation.